Hi everyone, I'm Manuela with Plytix. In this video, you're gonna learn all about product attributes, what a product attribute is, the different attribute types, and how using the correct type can help you with data validation, keeping your product information clean, organized, and easy to manage in Plytix. A product attribute is any piece of information related to a product. Other systems may call these data points, properties, values, or fields, amongst other things, but these all refer to the same thing. Let's look at the product page for this tote bag here. Almost everything you see here is a product attribute. We have the product name or label, product price, color, an image, the description. Then there's internal information that you won't see here, like the product ID, product owner, lifecycle stage. All of these are examples of product attributes, and these attributes are all needed to manage, market, and sell a product. The number of attributes that a product can have can range from a few to a few hundred. It all depends on the product. For example, on the one hand, a pencil might only have a few attributes, maybe the usual ones like name, description, color, and price, to name a few. While a car will have hundreds of attributes like number of doors, window type, engine type, specifications, warranties, not to mention all of the internal attributes. While your Plytix account will already come with some default system attributes, which you can learn more about in the video that I'm linking somewhere up here, you can also create as many custom attributes as you need to in order to store all of your product information. But when you're dealing with many attributes, it's easy to get overwhelmed, and it's also easy to make errors or mix attributes up, which is why, to give you a level of control, when you create a product attribute field, you can choose which attribute type you want to use. Attribute type refers to the type of information that an attribute can hold. In Plytix, we have different attribute types that allow you to hold all kinds of information. Each attribute type has a different way of displaying and filtering this information, which is why it's crucial to choose the right attribute type depending on the information that you want to store. So let's take a look at what these are and what they're best used for. You can use the timestamps in the description to skip to a specific part of this video and learn about a specific attribute type. First up, I'll show you the text attribute types: short text, paragraph, and HTML, and explain how they differ. Let's begin with the short text attribute type and the paragraph attribute type. Today, these can be used interchangeably, and pretty soon we'll actually be combining them into one attribute type. The reason we're doing this is that before, what differentiated the two is how they were displayed in the product table. The short attribute type would display the entire text, while the paragraph type would only display the first two lines. But we've made updates to our product table that allows you to adjust column sizes, so you can see however much you want to see. So for now, you can choose whichever one you want. The values you'd keep in a short text or paragraph attribute is anything that includes plain text. So for example, the product title, a product identifier that includes letters, alt text, metadata, product descriptions, basically attributes that have some unique content, rather than attributes like color or manufacturer that could be the same for many products. Those are better off being in a dropdown or a multi-select attribute type, but more on that later. What's really cool about the text attribute types is that you can actually set a character limit on them, which is important when you're working with attributes that have specific requirements like alt text or meta descriptions, and it allows for a level of data validation. Do keep in mind that the short text and the paragraph attribute types only allow simple text. If you want to store HTML text, you'd use the HTML attribute type. The HTML attribute type is, you guessed it, for storing HTML or rich text. This is useful if you want to set up a product description with formatted text that make use of bold text, italics, different fonts and sizes, or if you want to embed an image, a video, or a link within the text. Working with an HTML attribute is very easy thanks to our rich text editor. But if you have somebody who prefers to work in HTML code, they can do so by switching to the code view like you see here. Just keep in mind that the HTML attribute only supports HTML code, it doesn't support JavaScript. Next up, we have the integer and decimal attribute types. Both of these attribute types are numerical inputs. The difference being is that the integer attribute type only allows for whole numbers, while the decimal attribute type allows for decimals. The integer attribute type is perfect for attributes like maximum order quantity, image position, HS code, international article number, and so on. The decimal attribute type is perfect for attributes like different kinds of prices, size dimensions, and even time attributes like battery life. The great thing about using these attribute types is that if you or someone on your team tries to input an incorrect value, that is, input a value that's not in a number format. So let's say you try to write out the number 3, or you try to add a decimal, as you can see, the system won't let you. This helps keep consistency across all of your products and attributes. It also makes it easier to find and change information quickly and accurately. When filtering on a number, you can set conditions like greater than, less than, and equal to narrow down your searches and make bulk changes. Next up, there is the dropdown attributes. When you have data that includes a set of options, but only one option can apply at a time, then you'll want to use the dropdown attribute type. Using a dropdown instead of a free text field ensures that options are kept uniform. For example, let's say you want to allow for the color option blue. It seems pretty straightforward, but by making this a dropdown, you can keep users from accidentally inputting blue in the wrong case format, misspelling it, or adding options that shouldn't exist, like baby blue or light blue. Other attributes that would benefit from being in a dropdown are size, manufacturer, product owner, different statuses, and things like that. On the other hand, when you have data that includes a set of options and multiple options can apply simultaneously, then you'll want to use the multi-select attribute type. Like with dropdown attributes, you can have predefined options. This way you can select all of the ones that apply. Shopify tags, included accessories, color combinations, available retail outlets. These are all examples of attributes that go well with the multi-select attribute type. We also have a date attribute type that's perfect for attributes like launch date, expiration date, approval date. You get the gist, right? There are so many different ways of formatting a date that it can get a bit confusing, especially when you're dealing with different parts of the world. For example, in the US, you're likely to see June 1st as 06/01, but in many other countries, 06/01 is actually January 6th. Not to mention that some people use slashes, other people use dashes, other people write them out. There are a lot of different ways. But with a date attribute type, you can ensure that everyone is writing the date the same way. And you can even define how you want that date to be formatted on export. So you can quickly change the format for different regions. I'm dropping a link on how to format date attributes in the description if you want to check that out. Next up, we have a URL attribute. URL attribute types allow you to input a URL. Of course, you can input a URL in a text attribute as well, but the difference here is that the URL attribute type makes that URL clickable. It also means that you're only allowed to input a valid URL. If it's not valid, then you'll get an error message. This attribute type is great if you want to link to an external resource like a YouTube video, external documentation, or make a product's product page on different channels quickly accessible for internal purposes. We have a Boolean type attribute, which allows for only one of two possible values. Think of it like a yes or no or a true or false. There are so many different uses for this. You can use it to track if something is included, like batteries. You can use it to denote different features, like is it dishwasher safe? Is it microwave safe? Is it taxable? Things like that. Now let's talk about media attribute types. Media attributes allow you to attach a digital asset or assets. In Plytix, we have two separate attributes for this, media single and media gallery. As you can infer from the names, a media single attribute type allows you to include one digital asset. Examples of this would be thumbnail, barcode, main image, user manual. Media galleries, on the other hand, allow you to include various assets. So for example, awards, certificates, lifestyle photos, UGC. All of the attributes I've just named help you store information for your products in an efficient way. But we have two special attribute types that help you take that to the next level. Completeness attributes and computed attributes. Completeness attributes help you track progress. You select a group of attributes that you want to track, and the completeness attribute will tell you which have been completed, meaning which have values added to them, and which are still missing information. Again, there are many uses for this. You can select the attributes related to marketing and track the completeness of marketing material. You can use it to track if your products are ready to be published to different sales channels. Check if attributes for a particular language are finished. The list goes on. Computed attributes, on the other hand, help you transform data. You've probably worked with formulas in spreadsheets. Computed attributes are basically that. With computed attributes, you can apply formulas or operations to attributes you have in your Plytix account and transform them. There's so much you can do with completeness attributes and with computed attributes that we have separate videos and articles on how to create them and how to make the most out of them. So make sure you check that out. I hope you found this video tutorial helpful. If you have any questions at all, don't hesitate to reach out to your customer success manager or talk with a member of the Plytix team by using the chat on our website. And of course, if this video was helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more product information management tips and tricks.